Make sure that the garbage is all the way down.
Yeah, I gotcha. I hear you. Hey, what's this? a little treasure trove. Check it out. Treasure trove.
Sabres, the important statistic, though not necessarily meaningful as far as the scoreboard is concerned, 15 shots for the Buffalo Sabres, just 3 for the Rangers. The Rangers didn't get their first shot until the period was halfway over. However, the Rangers are even thanks to the great goaltending of John Davidson. With me is the Ranger hero of Thursday night, Don Murdoch, who scored the big overtime goal. We want to look at it, but before that, what was the mood on the team after the initial goal, the one that you thought had won it for you, had been disallowed? And, of course, the same thing happened to the Sabres. Did you feel let down at all?
Well, you know, it's hard to be let down. You know, we couldn't see it from the box. We saw the light go on, and we all jumped on. And then, then the guy came up with it in his glove. And so, you know, it's let down, but you still got to keep coming back. And then when Garrett went and scored a few seconds later, I was a let down. And, and then they turned on and disallowed his goal. So, and then we would turn around and score it again about, I think it was another 37 seconds. So, it was pretty big for us. All the guys, they counted the Rangers out before playoffs. They didn't think we should have been in. And now we're here fighting for the third game ahead of a lot of other teams. So, we're pretty ready for the game.
Well, you were pretty happy after you scored that goal. And we want to show it to the viewers and have you tell us what was going through your mind and just how the puck went in the net. I know you had to take it out of the air, and that was hard enough to end the shot.
Yeah, here it is behind. Walnichuk put it up to Vickers and hit somebody's stick. And Korob and I jumped for it. I put it down and went between Edwards' legs.
That's like beating a taller man in a basketball tip-off. He ought to get it if you're both going into the air at the same time.
Yeah, right. Well, Korob went up with a stick first, and then he saw me there. I guess he was scared to take a penalty. And I just jumped and put it down in front of me and shot between Edwards' legs.
Don, the Rangers had a slump at the end of the season. Now, the Leafs have already proved that didn't mean anything to them. Were you concerned going into the playoffs that the Rangers had not been playing well, or do you think the way you're playing in this playoff series and the way the Leafs did just proves that doesn't mean a thing at all?
Well, in a way, I was concerned myself because, we come right down the final game, and, it's kind of hard to go in, it wasn't for the Maple Leafs, but, it's still in the back of your mind, it might be hard to go into playoffs. A slump coming in hand, but then we won our final game to at least get things going, and we come here, lost Buffalo 4-1, but I don't think it was a 4-1 game. Went back to Garden and beat them, and now we're back here again with other teams that are out. So it just shows you that you can't count anybody out in playoffs. Doesn't matter who's playing.
When you get the lines matched the way you want, you're up against the French Connection. Walter Kachuk trying to check Gilbert Perreault. What kind of a challenge is it for you to be on Richard Martin?
Well, it's a big challenge. Richard Martin's one heck of a hockey player. But, Walter, Sarge, Steve Vickers, and I talked about it, and we just said, look, when we're at our end, we'll watch them guys. And we're a pretty good scoring unit ourselves, and I think they're going to have to watch us when we're in their end. So I think that's what Marcel Pronovost knows. That's why he's trying to mix the lines up here. So that, Richard Martin's going to have to watch out for Don Murdoch, and Randy Robert has to watch out for Steve Vickers.
In fact, your line has outscored the French Connection so far in the series in the two games, is it not?
Yes, it has. We got the lone goal here, and we got two in New York. So we're doing pretty good against them.
How about the way Davidson played in the first period? First of all, does it concern you? You were outshot so badly, but secondly, could you get a lift because he's playing so well?
Well, John's playing really good. He played really good in New York for us. And we had a few penalties here, so they got some good shots here. And it's just like the first game we come here, Donny Edwards played well for them. And if you get a goalie that can make big saves for you, that's all part of playoff hockey. If he does his job, we'll try to do ours. And if you combine it, you'll be a winning team.
Well, Don, congratulations on the big goal the other night that has brought you here and us as well. Good luck the rest of the way.
Thank you very much.
Don Murdoch of the New York Rangers. Stanley Cup 78 continues in just a moment.
Short-handed. Here's Badnay back for New York. Rangers with 78 power play goals over the regular season. Here's Pat Hickey. Tries to center, gets it himself. He shoots, it scores! Hickey! And the Ranger power play clicks to put them back into the picture.
Hickey scored 40 goals during the regular season. Now, with less than a minute to play, with the man advantage loose in the box, the Rangers get on the score sheet. A big goal late in the second period. It puts them back into the hockey game. After trailing 3-0, it's now 3-1. A deflection there. Edwards looking down, wondering how in the world that got behind him, as he apparently had that corner well guarded. Hickey put it through somehow, and it's 3-1.
There'd be a hockey game or where it would be, and they've done a bang-up job in getting this telecast together, and we acknowledge that and thank them. Less than a minute to play in the game. Here we go with a fight. It's Gare after Vadney. They have one another in headlocks.
Gare had to take a run at him to get up high enough to start in at him. Gare, just a little man, and Badney, much taller, but they, you remember they tangled a little bit in the first period, and Gare wouldn't want to injure a hand now at this point. He's got a lot more hockey to play this year.
Back to the Ranger clock, which is being served by Newman.
They heard you, Dan.
5 minutes for high sticking and 5 minutes for fighting.
Oh, two
Buffalo penalties, number 18, Danny Gare. 5 minutes for fighting, 2 minutes for slashing, 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct, and a gross misconduct.
Oh, my goodness. That's trouble for Buffalo, as Gare took a gross misconduct penalty plus a 5 minute major plus two minors.
5 minutes for high sticking and 5 minutes for fighting. Gare, 5 minutes for fighting, 2 minutes for slashing, 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct, and a gross misconduct.
Here we go. Fotiu, in the last minute of play, comes to center for New York, fires it into the Buffalo zone. Esposito there to get it to Fotiu. Now Schoenfeld intercepting. Here's Schoenfeld to center ice. Circles back. Schoenfeld to Ramsey. He got it to the line. It's intercepted by Maloney. He clears it to center ice. Marois and Ramsey pushing one another. 25 seconds to play in the game. Schoenfeld for Buffalo. Trying to clear it. Clears it to Ramsey. Ramsey flips it to center. 15 seconds left. Now Marois and Ramsey get their sticks up. Here they go. Marois and Craig Ramsey at the Buffalo blue line. Marois trying to throw some uppercuts. Ramsey runs him in against the boards. And the linesman will try and separate Mario Marois and Craig Ramsey.
The Rangers obviously very frustrated, losing 4-1 to Buffalo. And now Mario, well, we have Nick Poitou along with Jim Schoenfeld. A lot of muscle wrapped up there. And Danny, while we have a delay here, let's look at that gross misconduct situation that will now affect Danny Gare. Any person incurring such a penalty shall be suspended for the balance of the game, well, there was only a few seconds left, and shall incur an automatic fine of $100, and the case shall be referred to the president of the league for further disciplinary action. So it could mean something further.
Now Poteau and Schoenfeld doing a little dance. They're trying to get a hand free to throw some punching as they finally separated Ramsey and Marois. And Poteau and Schoenfeld. Poteau lands some punches. Now Schoenfeld fights back. They go to the ice with Poteau winding up on top, and now in comes Bob Myers.
Oh, a couple of heavyweights throwing heavy lumber there. Poteau and Schoenfeld.
All this occurring with 7 seconds left in the game.
The Sabres really should try to divorce themselves from this. They've got to advance now against Philadelphia. And if you get throwing fists like that, it's easy to crack a knuckle, break a finger, take a stitch or three. And in Gare's case, it'll be interesting to see what happens when they decide if there's going to be further punishment for that gross misconduct penalty.
Poteau and Schoenfeld head for their respective dressing rooms.